Hi, this is Eric Martin with Board Game Geek. I'm here with designer and illustrator City Lowe from The Wood Games, looking at A Pleasant Journey to Neko, which I did not know what Neko Harbor was initially. I had to look it up as I was editing your designer diary, talking about the creation of the game. So, I did not realize, but we are going to Antarctica.
Yeah, we're going to Antarctica and to see the penguins there.
Okay.
And we build a ship line to finish our journey.
Yeah. Okay. So we will be building the ship line from various cards that all have different powers on them and different elements that will come into play during the course of the game.
Yes.
How do we acquire these cards?
Yeah. Basically, the main mechanic is rolling the dice. I mean, we will draft our dice first.
Okay.
So let's draft a bit like now. We roll the 6 dice and we pick one of them at the same time. So we choose it 1, 2, 3 and pick one.
Okay.
And we move the remaining dice to your next player. Yeah.
Okay.
So we will do this until we have 6 dice again. And we will use our dice to do some actions.
Okay.
So there are 3 main actions we can do. One is to use your dice to beat the card.
Okay.
Or you can exchange some fish, because the fish you can exchange some valuable resources.
Okay.
And the third one, you can activate the hub or the card effect.
Okay. Yes. So talking about hubs, you're building up an individual ship lane.
Yeah.
And the hub is going to be created from 2 separate cards, where you use the die value from one card and a power or special ability from another card.
Yeah.
So those will be different as you combine the cards together on your board.
So you have many combinations about the hubs.
Okay.
So yeah.
That's right. And high numbers are good for bidding, but low numbers are needed to activate the hubs.
Yes, you need a small number of dice to activate some effects or a hub. Yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So there are 7 kinds of the cards. They have different effects. Yeah, the main mechanic is about it, but there are more details about, like during your game, during your turn, you not only can do main actions, you can do as many as you want the free actions.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
Which is sometimes using resources to exchange things, or
you can change adjust your dice.
Okay.
Or get some you can move your ship. Yes. So move your ship is the most important part of this game.
Okay.
Because when you move the ship, you will spend 2 fuel.
Okay.
And you move to the next part. Okay. And you will also activate this part. Just like you put a dice there.
Okay.
And there are special rules. If there is a dice already, and you move the ship there, they will catch a fish.
Okay. In addition to getting the bonus for going here.
Yes.
Okay.
So if you move further, you get more points because you see more penguins here.
Okay.
Yeah.
So how does the game end? What are we building toward?
Yeah, we will. The game will process 2 periods.
Okay.
And yes, and each period ends, we will have the again scoring.
Okay.
And after the second period, again scoring, we will process 2 again scoring.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's a structure.
Okay,
yeah.
So we get points for seeing penguins.
Yes.
What else are we scoring points for as we play?
Yeah, when you move your ship, you get penguin points. And also for your car, you have penguin points.
Okay.
Yes, and also there are some car effects like this. So you will score for a game and scoring like this kind of cars.
Okay.
So there are so many kinds of ways to score your points. But be careful, do not to take too much interference token because you minus points from this. It means you do something harmful for and you disturb their life or something like that, or you do something aggressive, you might get interference token. Yeah.
So. Okay. All right. Thank you very much, City.
Yeah,
the overview. A Pleasant Journey to Neko from The Wood Games.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.